السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام
عليكم. The second lecture is Palestine issue of history today and tomorrow by our beloved Dr. Salah Sultan. As you know, Palestine in our heart. Palestine in the heart of all Muslims all over the world. And you know why? Because it is a masra of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله. المسجد الأقصى in Palestine. So المسجد الأقصى in our heart and Palestine in our heart. And the situation of Palestine or the situation in Palestine is considered the situation of all the Muslims. And the Palestine issue is not only the issue for the Palestinian, but it is an issue for all the Muslims all over the world. And if you know, and if you want to know more detail about the Palestinian issue, you should hear about one of the scientists who deals with this issue, Dr. Salah Sultan, and we wish you can get benefit from this lecture, inshallah. JazakAllah khair.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters, may Allah سبحانه وتعالى reward all of you. I ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى as he gathered us today and yesterday in this conference, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather us in the day of judgment under his shadow. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us, all of us, mercy. هم القوم لا يشقى بهم جليسهم. When someone among us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiven for all of us. And we have to have niyyah, intention, when to come to this conference. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look for our hearts and forgiven for all of us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all of us to the right path, to be the best, not only the good Muslim in this country or anywhere. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the motivation to work day and night for his sake, to make Palestine free, very close, بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى. I spent in Ramadan 23 days in Gaza. And this is the most longest time I stay in any country for visit. Only 1 week, 10 days the most likely. But in Gaza, I wish to stay there all my life. I love Palestine more than my kids, my wife, myself. Even I love my kids, my wife, so much. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. But wallahi, I have never think about issues more than Palestine. to make it free بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى. When the scholar we came together with Sheikh Al-Qaradawi, I asked him many times why we didn't do our duties toward Palestine. We need to establish new department for the union scholars in the, all over the world, and alhamdulillah we established this department, and we have mission, vision, goals, and follow up many and many activities about Palestine. Palestine is not only any land. I would like to say more than welcome to meet our brother Sheikh Mustafa Hussein. Alhamdulillah. يعني, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward him and gather all of us inshallah to make Palestine free inshallah. Close inshallah. Palestine is the second mosque in all over the world after Al-Masjid Al-Haram. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala built Al-Masjid Al-Haram, جعل الله إن أول بيت وضع للناس الذي ببكة مباركا وهدى للعالمين فيه آيات بينات مقام إبراهيم ومن دخله كان آمنا ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا. الله سبحانه وتعالى after he started his house Al-Kaaba in the land after 40 maybe 40 days 40 years Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started this mosque Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, and the name Al-Aqsa because it's not close to Al-Masjid Al-Haram. We have some distance between Al-Masjid Al-Haram and Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. And the most of messengers, they live around Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa on Palestine. Many and many messengers used to live in this land and go around. I'm very surprised today for the most Christians in the world. They support Israel. They have to work with us because this is the land of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam and the Maryam al-Batul. When I was studying the USA, I asked some of Christians, you know how many times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Maryam in the Quran? They have no idea. Some of them said 5 times, 3 times, 2 times. I said no. 103. مباشر 34 مرة ذكرت مريم وبالضمير العائد على مريم ومريم ابنة عمران التي أحصنت فرجها فنفخنا فيه من روحنا فيه وصدقت بكلمات ربها وكتبه وكانت من القانتين. سيدة مريم started everything in this land and the tallest Surah, chapter in the Quran, after Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Ali Imran, the family of Sayyida Maryam, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't reveal surah about the mother of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the family of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In this land, we have many and many Sayyidina Lut, Sayyidina Ibrahim, Sayyidina Musa, Sayyidina Isa, Sayyidina Ishaq, Sayyidina Yusuf. It is the land of prophets. And this is the only land in all over the world, not Mecca, in Al-Quds. Allah gathered all the prophets, all the messengers, at the night of Isra and Mi'raj. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed Imam of all of them. قال أحمد شوقي أسرى بك الله ليلا إذ ملائكه ورست في المسجد الأقصى على قدمي لما التقيت به ملتف بسيدهم كالشهب بالبدر أو كالجند بالعلم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gathered all the prophets. It didn't happen in Mecca. Even Mecca is the best area all over the world. But there's still some specific issues in this land. And Allah mentioned 6 times in the Quran the name of Al-Ard Al-Muqaddasa Wal-Baraka. Al-Baraka 13 times in this land. And the barakah not only in this land. Al-Ard Al-Muqaddasa Allati barakna fiha, barakna hawlaha. When you gather both words, barakna fiha, the blessing inside the land of Palestine, barakna hawlaha, around. And some scholars said it is until Egypt, until Iraq. Some scholars said until Sinai only, not all Egypt, and until Syria. But all the scholars said the land of Palestine, or the land of Palestine, it is Ijma'. All the scholars agree that all Palestine has blessing, barakah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And wallahi, when you live there, when you touch the land of Palestine, you will taste the sweetnesses of barakah. I used to visit the most the cities in the world, but the best area, the best land, I feel barakah, safety. It is Gaza for me. I didn't visit. I hope inshallah to go to Al-Quds, not under Israel passport or Israel stamp or regime. No, inshallah we'll go to Gaza, we'll go to Palestine, Al-Quds, Fatihin, inshallah, to open this land, to raise Israel from this area tamaman bi-idhni Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. I feel very safety there, very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believe me. I always read the Quran with very important basic ideas. When I read the Quran, I try to find out the standard from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the first issue. What's the standard for everything? For the faith, for the manners, for the rules in ibadat, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dealing with people, dealing between states, dealing between parents and the kids, husband, wife, relatives, neighbors, dealing about money, dealing about anything. What is the standard? What are the rules? This is the first issue. The second issue, what is the reality in our land. فقه الواقع. It is close or far from this standard. What is the distance between our reality and Islamic standard? And the third issue, how to change our reality to be close to our to Islamic standard. This is always in my mind. I used to read the Quran and made khatma to finish all the Holy Quran in Mecca, in Medina, in Bahrain, in Oman, in Jeddah, in America. I lived there 8 years. In Europe and Russia, wallahi, wallahi, about the barakah and to be close to Allah, the best area I feel it is very close to the standard is Gaza. When you read about any ayah in Mecca about jihad, you will find big gap between the reality and Islamic standard. But if you read it in Gaza, you will find in front of your eyes Mujahideen. Not Mujahideen to kill each other, to kill innocent people. No. Mujahideen to fight Israel. They came from many countries to conquer our lands and they kicked out 6 million Muslim Arabs from Palestine. 6 million people. Some people cry about 1, 2, 3 cases of people there or here. 6 million people. And now we have more than 5,000 brothers and sisters in the jail of Israel. 5,000 people. In Islam, if you have only one, then asir, yani Arabi. Prisoner, yes. If you have only one prisoner, or asir, the prisoner in school. Asir. No, arrested, no.
Captive,
yes, asir. If you have only one asir, captive, with your enemy, Imam Malik, radiallahu anhu, said, all the Muslim, they are asimin. They have big sin. If they didn't work day and night to make them free or make him free. ثم قال لو أسر مسلم واحد وجب على المسلمين في الأرض جميعا أن يفكوا أسيرهم ولو استغرق ذلك جميع أموالهم. If the Muslim have one captive, one, the enemy take only one among us and keep him the prisoner. All the Muslims have to work to make him free, even they spend all their money, they own money, all of them, for one Muslim, just one. I feel shame when Israel work day and night and encourage every country to work for one of captive of them. Shalit, you know Shalit? Shalit, the only one, our brother in Gaza, they catch him and they keep him there 5 years. And they pushed Egypt, Jordan, some of another Islamic countries, America, the most countries in Europe, Germany, Chinese, Russia, to make their effort to make him free. just one. But all our ummah, we go to pray 5 times daily beside each other. I don't feel responsibility about our brothers and the prisoner and the jail in Palestine, 5,000 people. You know, daily, for those brothers, they break them, our brothers or sisters, and make them to take off all the clothes, and very hard to tell about many and many bad things happened there against our sisters. And the Muslim go to pray, recite Quran, and eat, enjoy their life without feeling full responsibility about Palestine. I'm telling you, as the man who study from more than 35 years, read day and night about Sharia, about Usul al-Fiqh, about Fiqh. If you pray 100 rak'ah every day, if you fast every day, if you spend all your money, if you make Umrah every month, if you make Hajj every year, if you do as much as you can to help your neighbors without concerning working to make Palestine free, we have big sin. We are fasiqeen. We are athimeen. If you don't work for the sake of Allah to make Palestine free from those people, Israeli, who came from everywhere to conquer our land and kill our brothers, and still day and night change everything. Tawheed. Tawheed to change everything. The history, the reality, and even the graveyards. You know, the grave of Ma'manullah, for example. Grave Ma'manullah, it has more than 70,000 Muslims in this grave. More than 50 of companions, they are there in this grave. Tabi'een, many and many of Tabi'een. The Palestinian came and made this land, it is graveyard, grave, and got the trash, all the trash on this land. And they made al-Magari, Amr al-Magari, sewage water in this area and change everything under al-Masjid al-Aqsa. Al-Nafaq, yani. Tunnels, yeah. They made 39 tunnels under al-Masjid al-Aqsa. 90 meters under al-Masjid al-Aqsa. To destroy it very easy, and if we have very little earthquake, or maybe they will make pump by the plane, anything, very little. Now al-Masjid al-Aqsa, like something in the, without any qawa'id or basic thing to carry this al-Masjid al-Aqsa. 90 meters, tunnels. The number is 39 under al-Masjid al-Aqsa. Our Prophet Muhammad, this is the last destination for Isra and the first destination for al-Mi'raj. All of this barakah, all the this history, our Prophet Muhammad wanted before he died to see are the Palestine land free from the Roman. And Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, the only land He went from Medina to Mecca, to Al-Quds, to Palestine, to receive by himself the key of Al-Quds. And he stayed there, you know, at this night. When he went, Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, the leader was Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah. After they finished, he felt very hungry. He needs to eat. He needs to eat, Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu. And he asked Sayyidina Abu Ubaidah, why you don't invite me to eat? In the same night, he received the key of Al-Quds and open Al-Quds, make it free. And Sayyidina Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah قال لا أريد أن تعصر عينك يا أمير المؤمنين إذا جئت إلى بيتي وإلى طعامي ستعصر عينك من البكاء. ثم ذهب فأكل خبزا وملحا جريشا. Just very hard food and some of salt. Bread and salt. Just this all food at this night. And they decided in the same night, Umar ibn Khattab, Amr ibn al-As, Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah, Khalid ibn Walid, four of them, if we need to keep Al-Quds free without any threat from the Roman or others, we have to open Egypt. And they decided in the same mind to open Egypt. لأنهم اعتبروا الأمن الاستراتيجي لفلسطين هي مصر. And they decided and started to open Egypt. We spent 30 years with the regime of Hosni Mubarak. When we say anything about Palestine, when we pray Salat al-Jum'ah, they took us to the jail. And we received a lot of punishment because we concerned about Palestine. You know, wallahi, we spent in the jail in Egypt 45 brothers. Just the area 5 and 6 meters, 30 meter مكعب يعني. نعم؟ متر سكوير. 35 كل واحد يقول بسمك اللهم أحشر جنبي وبسمك اللهم أنزعه. Just because we work against Israel, not against our government, but our government, that before revelation, they work day and night with Israel against the Egyptian, against the Arabs, against the Muslim nation, against the human beings. And this is one of the reasons Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us victory against Hosni Mubarak and Umar Sulaiman and those people. My dear brothers and sisters, the situation now very hard in Palestine. Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, anytime you can find it destroyed, you will not see Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. And then, no any good thing can make us free in the Day of Judgment, except to bring again Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, Al-Quds, Palestine, our brothers in the jail, all of them free. The situation now about the people who left long time until now. Imagine yourself, you have your own your hands. house. And at night, the police from Israel come with people, مستعمرين, مستغلين, محتلين, and they kick out from your house, and they stay in the same house, and the government give them the people you own, the Israeli family own this house without nothing. Once I was in the flight from Detroit to Philadelphia in America. Under my seat beside American man, I started to make dialogue with him, as usual, to give him message about Islam, to advise him to be Muslim. This is, I have always done. And he told me I am American and Israeli. He has two citizens. And he gave me album. He went every year, spent his vacation yearly. Think about ourselves. Yearly. Go to Israel and carry the Silah, the weapon, and kill some Palestinian. And they feel honored. I do it here. I go to be with the army of Israel. And they give me some picture. Carry the arm and it. And they told me, why you think as very stupid people? You are, as Arab and the Muslim, very stupid. America is covered all the time Israel. Always support Israel. How can you think you will come against America? You cannot have any victory. I told him, if you think deeply, you are very stupid. Because America supports Israel, and Allah is the only one who supports us. والله غالب على أمره ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only power in all over the world. If you worship Allah, do your duty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised 100 times in His Quran, وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِنَّا لَنَنْصُرُ رُسُلَنَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْأَشْهَادُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُدَافِعُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ خَوَّانٍ كَفُورٍ أذن الذين يقاتلون بأنهم ظلموا وإن الله على نصرهم لقدير ولقد سبقت كلمتنا لعبادنا المرسلين إنهم لهم المنصورون وإن جدنا لهم الغالبون. I mentioned some of ayahs, all of these ayahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise. Allah promise our ummah to support, to give them the power to be inshallah the best, to be very strong, to have victory, to come over. This is promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from any state, not from any man, not from anyone. It is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I told him, please see this small boy and this strong man, youth, and this old man. We have already everywhere these three kinds of people. I said to him, You are now America and Israel like this youth. Strong man. Nearly, inshallah, very close, you will be like this elder. He can't stand. He will walk like this. This is America tomorrow and Israel. And this child tomorrow, inshallah, will be youth, very strong. It is natural for people, for animals, for plants, for anything. Even the sun every day. The sun starts like this and make lights for everything in the land. And go again. And this is the moon also. Start very short, very, and the moon, full moon. It is happened everywhere. And I told him also, don't think America take care about to the Israeli, the Jewish in the world is only not 20 million. 13 million all over the world. Even they are 20 million. It is not wisdom to take care of 20 million and ignoring 1.7 billion people in the world. The Muslim Ummah are 1.7 billion. Maybe sometime very weak, lakin alhamdulillah, they are getting better. And believe me, I didn't visit any country. And go again to this country, I find Islam is over, alhamdulillah. Bigger, stronger, fadlillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. Look at Tokyo only. 15 years ago, in Tokyo, we have only two Islamic centers. Now we have 45 Islamic centers in Tokyo only. Look at the USA. 15 years ago, we have only 8 Islamic centers in all over the USA and Canada, north of the of America. Now we have 3,000 Islamic centers in the North America. In Europe, we have 55 million Muslims in Europe. And we have very strong organizations in Europe. In France, within 3 years, 45,000 original from France convert to Islam within 3 years. And Germany within 10 years, 200,000 from Germany convert to Islam. When you visit Russia, before that they destroyed 160 mosque and church because they need to destroy everything of religion. Now every week we have new mosque in Russia. Every week we have another new mosque. And when you visit the University of Moscow, you will find Islamic college inside. And they invite me to be the head of the committee to test the people who memorize Quran from all over the world. اللجنة الدولية ل أو المسابقة الدولية لحفظ القرآن الكريم. Russia. And the ambassador in Bahrain from Russia called me, Dr. Sultan, could you please come 5 minutes to give you visa to visit Russia to be the head of the committee to test the people from 26 countries come to the competition of Mraz al-Quran. I told them, you are really the ambassador from Russia. الرقم غلط ولا الكلام صح يعني it is really I said, yes I told them 20 years ago the government in Russia if they find only just one paper of Mus'haf one paper of Mus'haf they will kill him if they find just one paper of Mus'haf in your pocket in your house in your bag now alhamdulillah روسيا بتعمل مسابقة دولية بيجيها ناس من 26 دولة. And I went, I was very surprised. One of kid, 10 years old, read all the Holy Quran. If you recite just two words from any ayah, he will say all the ayah, he will tell you what is the number of this ayah, and what is the surah, what is the number, what is the chapter, it is on right page or left page, 10 years old. I told him, this American Israeli man, tomorrow inshallah, this is 10 years ago, this is the dialogue. Tomorrow inshallah you will find something big happen in the world. It changed everything. I am telling you also, don't be late to support Palestine. Tomorrow Palestine, inshallah, will be free. And if you stay at home, just look for the news, follow what happened there or here, and just make dua in your room. It is not enough. لا يستوي منكم من أنفق من قبل الفتح وقاتل أولئك أعظم درجة من الذين أنفقوا من بعد وقاتلوا وكلا وعد الله الحسنى. Don't feel you are good without Palestine. We are not. We are not. In Palestine, people under suffering. Day and night, people that haven't the basic for life, and Israelis have everything. They took the water under the earth to drink, to get a shower, to do everything, and nothing. 95% of people in Gaza have no clean water. They drink bad water. ماء ملوث. 85% of our brothers in Gaza because the siege around them from Islamic country, from Israel. 85, they are poor. Poor. They have no enough. For the basic to live. الحياة الكريمة، الكفاف، الكفاية. But والله, I found them, they challenge two things. Challenge the siege, it challenge the army of Israel. Our brothers in Gaza challenge both. And alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them full success, Fadlillahi Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. You hear about the bomb and the killing and at 19 and 2009. They came to destroy everything in Gaza. And they made everything forbidden in the world, for the rules, everything. Everything. They made very close what America did here in Japan, they mean very close to this. And alhamdulillah, they fight, and Allah gave them victory. Bifadlillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. Israel came with their weapons, with armies, with everything. America full support, Europe full support. Most of the country in the world sent to them whatever they want, money, weapons, everything. But our brothers, we can't in Egypt, in Saudi Arabia, we can't go out to say, stop this war. The people work in internet, اللي تعرفت اسمها المقاومة الإلكترونية. It was good. But if you do anything, they put you in the jail. But in the end, they came for three reasons. To destroy Hamas, to take Shalit, to stop الصواريخ اللي besides, yes. And they failed for three things. Alhamdulillah. And our brothers still, alhamdulillah, stand in their foot, and alhamdulillah, they do the most important challenge in anywhere in the world. I met brothers, and I visit every embassy, every minister in Gaza. I visit most of the Islamic centers, the mosques. I visit the patient. I visit the family who give many family. They have, one family have 17 shaheed. 17 shaheed, one family. Now, what's our duties? What's our duties? Number one, please, and please, and please, not to make something good for your life, no. To save ourselves from the hellfire. Number one, we have to read about this land, Ard al-Muqaddasa, the Holy Land, about the history of this land, about the reality in this land, about the future, inshallah, of this land. Read, follow up the news, as it is your family there, it is your land. I mentioned to the governor of New York. I went to New York and gathered the imams, the Islamic centers to pray Salat al-Eid together. We were in Brooklyn, 25,000 people pray in one place. And the 15,000 out of the place, the police didn't allow them to come in because it was very crowded. For the safety issue, 40,000 the same area. And the governor came to us to say congratulations for your Eid, Eid al-Fitr. I told him, tell the government in America, our land in Palestine, for the real Muslim, in the world, in anywhere in the world, it is better than his home. الأرض المقدسة أحب إلينا من بيوتنا التي نسكن فيها. القدس وفلسطين, we love it, we concern about it more than our whom we used to live in. And we cannot accept this full support from America to Israel. I need to feel this land, it is our land. This Masjid al-Aqsa is our mosque. Our brothers there, our brothers and sisters. If, لا قدر الله, you have an accident in your family and your father in the hospital, your mother in another hospital, your wife in another hospital, your kids, because everyone has to have surgery. Do you will concern only about your wife and ignoring your mother and father, ignoring your kids? Do you will concern about, you will treat and take care of your kids, ignoring your parents? Do you will concern about your parents, ignoring your wife and the kids? No. Don't tell me I have a problem here. I have to take care of my wife, my kids, my study, my parents, my... It's true, you have to take care of them. But, إنما المؤمنون إخوة. مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم كمثل الجسد الواحد. إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر جسده بالسهر والحمى. We are like the only, the one body. If you have any disease in anywhere in your body, you feel about this disease, this pain anywhere in your body. This number one, knowledge and feeling. Knowledge, to know daily. If you have your family like I mentioned, if you didn't go to visit your father, you will call. Oh, today, what the doctor said, oh, alhamdulillah, today is better, alhamdulillah, you have enough medication. The doctor visit you, tomorrow what will happen? Oh my, you need some money. This is the normal feeling if you have an accident habit in your family. And it is habit. It is normal. I can't sleep any day without go to the news and know what the last thing happened daily because they are my family. They are the bottom of my heart. They are part of my body, my mind, my heart, everything. Knowledge and feeling. Number two, start to change your life, to be the part of the people who will make Palestine free, inshallah ta'ala, and to establish new organization, Harakat Umana al-Aqsa. Harakat Umana al-Aqsa, we established this organization for youth, for people, for sisters. Alhamdulillah, today I talk with them, with the part of them. We, alhamdulillah, started 1 year ago, 1 year and 2 months. We are the first people who went to the embassy in Israel in Egypt, when Israel killed 7 soldiers, Egyptian soldiers in China, in Sina. They came and they killed 7 people. And we asked our government at this time to kick out the ambassador. They refused to do anything. I went to the mosque in Salat al-Jum'ah and delivered Khutbah al-Jum'ah. All of you, go with me please to the embassy. We need to end this story. And alhamdulillah, we went and made the flag. We went there, we are the first group went to this area. We start with very small group, 500 people. After 3 hours, about 500 people. I went to the TV and asked people to come there with many scholars. I called many scholars, and alhamdulillah, the end. Around 50,000 people around the ambassador in Israel, in Egypt. And alhamdulillah, Ahmed Shahad go up and make the flag down. and they left this area. Until now, they have no area, no space in Egypt to have another embassy. Nobody rent to them or buy any area to Israeli ambassador. Alhamdulillah. Work start with very little thing. Harakat Manai al-Aqsa, I have group, I have to be with them. And Gaza, they went 3 days ago, 4 days ago. When I come here, they already go to group from Harakat Manai al-Aqsa. They went to Egypt. I called them within Salat al-Fajr. Alhamdulillah, they are very happy. Try to visit Gaza, to see by your eyes. Family, take your family as a visit. Remember this American man every year, he takes his vacation in Palestine and support Israel and carry his whip and kill and some Palestinian every year. I ask you to go once, to see by your eyes, to be the part of activities. In the MSA, and in over the world, they are the best to work for Palestine. The youth, the intelligent people, the master degree, and the PhD professors, encourage your student, just read the reality. You will find a lot to tell your student, to tell your friends, to tell the community, Muslim, non-Muslim, human being in the world. In Lebanon, they started new organization for research. The name is Al-Zaytuna. Please, go to read in English, in Arabic, in Urdu, Al-Zaytuna. Merkez Zaytuna, they translated their books to English to many. And read about something like this and deliver this message. Those brothers, they made 11 books until now. They made 100 books, but 11 books under the name Awalastu Insana. Awalastu Insana. How? ترجمتها.
I'm not a human being.
Awalastu. Aren't we human beings? I am a man. I live in my land. I live in my home. Some people came from everywhere and kicked me out from my home. I am a human being. I need to live with peace. But those people come to make it war. Read and tell others, Muslim or non-Muslim. هذه القضية, we need to make Palestinian issue very important for three kind of people. Muslim, Arabs, human beings, أي إنسان في العالم. Non-Muslim. Any human beings look for the people in Palestine. Look for the land of Palestine. Look for the holy mosque, al-Masjid al-Aqsa. What happened? Look for our graves. Look for our hostage. They change everything. Please donate as much as you can. I don't come today to collect money. No. I need everyone among you to make monthly some money to support our brothers and sisters in Palestine, not only Gaza, Gaza and all Palestine, to be very strong. They need everything, everything. If you don't have enough money, go as a physician. I, wallahi, pray to Allah to give full mercy for brothers and sisters came from Egypt, from Morocco, from Malaysia, from everywhere. During the time of war, upon Gaza and dwelt under the weapon, under the very bad situation to treat our brothers and sisters and the kids in Gaza. They went. Some of them stayed 4 days in the board between Egypt and Palestine to get in. And he decided to get in. Alhamdulillah now, Alhamdulillah, in Egypt government, they will change everything. We have agreement with Dr. Morsi, the president, about Palestine, about Gaza, to work day and night. We'll visit him after he became the president. Actually, Alhamdulillah, we used to go with him every state in Egypt to encourage people to vote for Dr. Morsi. I was the part of his group to go everywhere, Alhamdulillah. I told him when I visit him after I became president, I need you to fulfill your promise before you became president to support Palestine, full support. And he said, Dr. Sultan, نصيحتك وتعيها أذن وعي بإذن الله ستجدني خيرا مما تتمنى. And I hope, inshallah, the future will be very good. So please, all of you, be a part of any organization. Start organization. Start to do something organization here in Japan. And spread this idea everywhere. Go to the website Harakat Umanai Al-Aqsa and see how very little kids, very small group. Alhamdulillah, now we are more than 50,000 members of Harakat Umanai Al-Aqsa. Very little. Our youth, yeah, in high school, they go to the mall and start to talk with people. Please, do you know about Palestine? Come, I give you some idea. In the mall, not only in the mosque, not only in the street, everywhere, Alhamdulillah, we try to spread this idea everywhere. For reading and the feeling and support by money, support by your effort, establish with any organization. Establish some organization here to support Palestine or be a part or member of any organization, support our brothers in Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of you. جزاكم الله خيرا وشكر الله لكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
جزاكم الله خيرا Professor Dr. Salah Sultan about this interesting lecture. And unfortunately, a few minutes only for the open discussion, so there is a question.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Muhammadin from Piamo University. I'd like to ask, the first question is about the promise that has been made by Dr. Muhammad Morsi to you. Could you please translate it to us in English?
Dr. Morsi, before he became president, he made promise to support Palestine to make it free. Not only to support people by money, open the sea between Egypt and Gaza and Palestine, and to make Palestine free. And we work on it, but step by step. My statement of that, نبني مصرنا ونحرر قدسنا. We'll build our Egypt country and we'll make Palestine free, inshallah. بإذن الله تعالى. Actually, we cannot do our plan without making Egypt very strong. And as the history, if Syria and Egypt strong in Islamic country, they will come to do like this in Israel. Believe me, most of Israelians will leave Palestine بيد الله تعالى. If the victory complete in Syria, Egypt and the Palestine and the Syria establish يعني very strong country for the economic, for media, for political, for social, for education, for every aspect. Egypt and Syria. Syria will يعني as a from the east, Egypt from the west, and don't forget Turkey, alhamdulillah, getting better, and they work alhamdulillah against Israel now, and maybe we will make يعني siege around Israel, they will go out inshallah. Don't think this is a very simple or حاجة كده تافهة يعني أو سطحية. No, Allah. It is true. We'll find that tomorrow. بإذن الله. إن شاء الله. جزاك الله خير.
السلام عليكم. My name is Shehzad from Uzbekistan.
From
Uzbekistan.
Uzbekistan.
I want to ask.
I visit Uzbekistan.
I want to ask two questions. One is Jewish people say that it's their promised place. Is it true? Is there any sentence in the Quran? Or what about we think? What about how about it? And my second question is about boycott. Is there any believable source that some brands supporting Israel or Jewish people, and we
from what
brand any brands.
Brands.
Any company or any factory which supporting Israel or Jewish, and we don't buy their products in any believable source. And I think this is also one aspect we can do, we can afford.
Zakallahu khairan, this is a very good question. This land started from Arabs. The name is Kanaaniyin, Al-Yubisiyin. And the Israelian came only, yani we have 3,000 years Arabs. And Israel only came 400 years. And it is only Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, when he came not for all the human being in the world, but he came as the term and the end by Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, and all of them end by Sayyidina Muhammad. For that, our Prophet Muhammad salam, when he prayed Imam upon in the front of all the messenger, it means we inherit everything. At the same time, we open the door for any religion to come to this land. And if you go to the history, when Muslim Ummah controlled their land, they opened the door for people from any religion, Christian, Jewish, any religion, to come to visit. Even he is the only original from this land, he can pray, he can do according to his religion without any bushing, without any bad things. Yeah. When Israel come now, you cannot, if you are Palestinian and live in Al-Quds, you cannot pray at Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. You only after 45 years, they allowed them to go to inside Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. They prevent anyone of youth, of kids, to go there. And they control everything around Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. And when we have the state in this land, we open the door for others. When they have the state in this land, the zulm by transgression and the mischief, and they prevent everybody. تاريخيا in the history issues they have no any right in this land and they didn't find anything about هيكل داود the هيكل what does it mean هيكل هيكل سليمان didn't find anything and سيدنا سليمان and داود they pray يعني بيها الأبرس صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني ف this is and also if you go to Zaytuna Institute you will find very deep knowledge about that if you go to also and write Dr. Radim Surjani he has very good search very good with يعني يعني he write يعني very good paper about that and read about you find a lot number two about your question if you go to Palestinian website you will find list of the companies who support Israel like McDonald's is big support to Israel Starbucks support the army specific and encourage another visitor another business people Jewish business people support the army not only support Israel as a state and the people support the army unfortunately we have a branch of Starbucks in the front of Masjid al-Aqsa Masjid al-Haram في وقف الملك عبد العزيز unfortunately I said that in the front of everybody in the world please close this Starbucks it is in the front of Masjid al-Haram we cannot accept that even Malik Abdul Aziz or Malik Abdullah or anybody control this country has duty to close Starbucks and every company who supports Israel this is his duty you can find the list of this company and this ours also our duties and I encourage our sisters please don't use the material the products from the companies who support Israel can we live without Coca-Cola yes absolutely yes Coca-Cola is a company who support Israel wallahi when we meet fatwa 10 years ago or 12 years ago I didn't put it in my mouth Coca-Cola why is there something here and when you come to eat Coca-Cola they support Israel you care our brothers and sisters the companies of cigarette they pay daily for Israel $10 million if you smoke you kill our brothers your brothers and sisters and kids in Palestine it is not only haram because it's harm your body it is also haram because these companies support Israel please wake up our brother and sister we don't go to paradise just to pray 2 rak'ahs at morning and 4 rak'ahs at evening and fasting in Ramadan no we kill our brothers and sisters in Palestine we made indirect way to support the companies Israel have nothing to do without this those companies the states who support Israel now لا يدونا شوية في الحوار معلش أهمية الموضوع يمكن 5 minutes another 5 minutes يوصل هذا الوجه معلش بس شوف أخواتنا
we need the last question because of time
بتقرا السؤال يا اختي ما فيهاش حاجه
السلام عليكم بالنسبة لنا كإخوان نساء يعني وخارج مصر ما الواجب ما الواجب الذي يستطيع أن نقوم به تجاه فلسطين؟ What is our duties as a woman of the from brotherhood towards Palestine?
I think our sisters, alhamdulillah, they can do a lot for Palestine, more than men, because you have kids and you encourage your husband or your family. Alhamdulillah, wallahi, when I visit Palestine, I found our sister there. They do a lot of things. When you visit Umm Nidal, he encouraged his son Nidal to start the first Saruch al-Hawa rocket, the first rocket against Israel. She encouraged his son daily. And alhamdulillah, when he finished, before he went to Ahmed Yassin, went to his mom and make signature in his discovery. Umm Nidal, I always yani, deal with her. This is a yani, woman can teach your kids, and it is a model example for all of you. I found many sisters. They have 3 or 4 shuhada. They built them very strong, her husband. 3 of her kids, 2 of his, her brother, the shuhada, try to deal with our sister there and start to support sisters. You know how many people, they lost their leg in Gaza. 700 people lost both legs. 12,000 people in jail. And they lost maybe his hand, his eye, his leg to 12,000 people. They need your support. You can make organization to collect money for those. You can make open house for non-Muslim to come to see the picture. Can print out from the internet the picture about Palestine, what happened there, what the situation there, invite non-Muslim. Even wallahi, if you sit in the plane and talk with others, you will find something to support. For our sisters, teach your kids. I found many, not only in Palestine, teach their kids the best thing he wished in his life, to be shaheed, to make Palestine free بإذن الله تعالى. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward my mother. She named me with my father, Salah al-Din. And they always told me, we made that to be new Salah al-Din in our ummah, to make Palestine free, always. Until wallahi, the last night she passed away, in the first month of this year, she told me, I hope to live until see you, to lead the Muslim Ummah to change, to make Palestine free. And she passed away. When I pray Salat al-Jum'ah, she passed away during the time of Sahar, in the day of Jum'ah. When I deliver khutbah in the same day, her body in the front of me, I promise, my mother, oh my mom, I promise Allah in the front of you to work day and night to fulfill your desire to make Palestine free. I will lead our ummah bi-idhnillahi ta'ala to make Palestine free. And I hope everyone of our ummah to help to do that together bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. وَيَقُولُونَ مَتَى هُوَ قل عسى أن يكون قريبا. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
ورحمة الله وبركاته. Thank you so much to love the brother of Salah Sultan about this interesting lecture. جزاكم الله خير.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So of course we have some shift in our schedule. So now we will go to pray, إن شاء الله تعالى. Pray الظهر and العصر for those who are far. coming from far away. And after that, we will come here to take the lunch. Then we will announce about the rest of the schedule, inshallah. And for females, we will close this partition